the book To Kill a Mockingbird is one that's been loved by generation after generation across several decades. A second book by the author Harper Lee has now been published. Ghosetta Watchman takes place in the mid-1950s, about 20 years after the trial that served as the centrepiece of To Kill a Mockingbird, which came out 50 years ago, would you believe?
Shall we hear the opening line? Cool.
Since Atlanta, she had looked out of the dining car window with a delight almost physical. Over her breakfast coffee, she watched the last of George's hills recede and the red earth appear.
Very good.
And the scene is set in just that one line. Well done, Sophie Cook, there, for reading that.
Well, Ghosetta Watchman actually takes place in the mid-1950s, about 20 years after the trial that served as the centrepiece to Kill a Mockingbird. As we mentioned, a number of bookstores, would you believe, were open at midnight for immediate sales, with some of the highest pre-orders for a book since the last in the Harry Potter series. Well, one woman who's actually waiting to get a copy is Judy Williams. She's an English tutor for Leicester Adult Learning Services. She's also, later this year, running a course in Leicester on To Kill a Mockingbird. I'm pleased to say she joins us on the programme. Judy, good morning.
Morning.
Ghosetta Watchman is highly anticipated, as we've been...
That's an understatement.
I know. How excited are you by it?
Oh, well, I've got my copy ordered and it's ready for me to pick up at 8 o'clock this morning. So as soon as I finish this interview and have my breakfast, I'm off.
I'm surprised you're not actually waiting outside the shop.
Well, if you hadn't called me, I might have.
the beauty of mobile phones. But look, for those of us that perhaps don't know it, what was the premise of To Kill a Mockingbird?
Well, To Kill a Mockingbird was actually the second book. Ghosetta Watchman came first, but Harper Lee's editor recommended that she put Ghosetta Watchman on the shelf and write To Kill a Mockingbird first. And I think that's because it took us back to the 1920s and was based on an incident that took place in the 30s, which was the Scottsboro trial, where nine African-Americans were accused of, males were accused of raping two white American women. So it was actually based on that. And the story was told through the eyes of Scout Jean Louise as a young child. So it kind of took us back from a lot of those very serious racial issues and racial violence and made us look at the humanity of what was being done.
Why do you think it was such a hit, though?
Because it was told in such a simplistic way and it immersed us in the life of deep South America in Alabama through the eyes of a child and made us look at ourselves. It made us hold a mirror up to the things that we did and question the rights and wrongs of it.
It's been interesting watching people queuing up for the book, and you know, both young and old, who are anticipating the release of this. Can Ghosetta Watchman, do you think, live up to the hype?
Oh, that's a tough question. I can only answer it from a personal point of view and say I don't think so, because To Kill a Mockingbird came first and was absolutely a wonderful story and beautifully told and completely transported me when I first read it as a teenager. So I don't think anything will ever live up to that, but I am looking forward to it.
Do you think that's why Harper Lee has sat on it for so many years and just, you know, refused to release it until now?
She actually thought it was lost. She apparently it was in the editor's safe it's been in there all these years until it was recently found by her agent. So Harper Lee actually thought the first transcript was lost.
That's fascinating. I didn't know that. Mm-hmm. But of course, this story is set considerably after To Kill a Mockingbird, isn't it? And Jean Louise Scout is the woman in question, as she's sitting on that train, as described there in the opening line of the new book, heading back for her annual visit. I've read the first chapter, Judy. Have you? And if so, what did you think?
No, I've deliberately tried
You've held
not
off.
To read
All right,
anything
okay.
about
We promised no spoilers this morning. We promised no spoilers. But we do know there is a big twist
yes.
in this book. And there is a bombshell in chapter one as well, which is...
Stop it,
Neil. Don't tell me.
I gasped out loud, but, you know, I won't say any more right now. How excited are you on a scale of 1 to 10, then?
I try not to go up to 10 too often. The old heart can't take it. But put me at around 8, 9. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to this.
It's interesting, Judith, because you're actually holding a course later this year as well on Mockingbird, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm running that for the WEA, the Workers Educational Association in Leicester. And they actually put a call out for this maybe about 4 or 5 months ago. And as soon as I saw it, I thought, yay, great. They always give me an opportunity to run courses in a way that I like to run them, because predominantly I teach To Kill a Mockingbird for GCSE English. So we're going to be looking, it's a 7-week course. It's going to be at Highgate's shopping centre in their marketing suite. And we're going to be comparing Go Set a Watchman to Kill a Mockingbird, and looking at how the issues and the themes are treated between the two.
Do you think in the future, you know, Go Set a Watchman is a book that you might be looking at in the future?
It's not,
you know,
ready,
courses.
Yeah.
Well, no, but, you know, from all the hype, do you think?
It's difficult to say, because for GCSE English, it's actually been taken off the syllabus from... this is the last year I'll be able to teach it, because we're returning back to English literature.
Yeah, it's very, very rare for a piece of American literature that is so firmly set in American contemporary history to become part of, I suppose, the English national curriculum, isn't it?
Well, for the last 10 years or so, no, because it was they opened up the English curriculum to include English language literature.
Okay.
So it did become quite normal, but we were kind of returning back to our roots a bit.
Well, look, Judy, thanks for joining us on the programme. I know you probably want to get off, because
yes,
you've got two minutes. There's probably a queue now,
because
you waited to chat to us. I'm sorry, but you probably lost out. You're going to have to wait at least. No, look,
you can
good
walk
luck
to the front because you pre-ordered.
Thanks.
Enjoy it. Let us know what you thought of it, won't you?
Will do. Thank you for calling.
Julie Williams there, an English tutor for the Leicester Adult Learning Services, who's also running a course in Leicester, as you've just heard, to Kill a Mockingbird.